In the beginning, there were words. For no sky nor dirt, rocks nor birds, heaven nor earth, death nor birth had yet been given proper syllabification. So nothing physical had yet entered creation. But despite the lacking of material manifestations, there did hang one true enunciation. Words. Words of God, spoken script, speaking scripture, holy writ, the writing builder, building mountains out of nouns, plants and herbs from active verbs, planting nations in punctuation, preparing solar positions with prepositions. Nature's narrative was rich with adjectives, but man was dirt and needed an additive, so God added his imperative, impairing the dirt of its ability to be sedative. So came the breath of life, the words that made dirt our relative. We are born of Bible, letters formed our limbs. How can I deny God's words when they are written on my skin? In this breath of life, God breathed to begin, an exhalation for the ages, the inspiration of men. You know the words of which I speak. You've memorized them. They are the Pentateuch, Torah, history books, poets, major and minor prophets, synoptic gospels, Acts of the Apostles, and their epistles. They are our scriptures, those ancient divine whispers scribed by enlightened scriptors passed down to modern listeners. The mouth from which the universe was founded is the fount on which our scriptures are grounded. Listen to where the Bible was originally sounded, for it's far better than what we have lobbied, or from traditions copied, or our own doctrines embodied. That scripture says, that scripture is God breathed. That means the breath that filled the nostrils of the ground, the life blown into dirt, the exhaling heartbeat that made the simple renowned. That is what can be found in what has been written down. So I believe in the scriptures, where God has breathed the breath of life, where we find the vows between eternal husband and earthly wife, where saints and martyrs find comfort for their strife and stone hearts come to get cut with a knife. I believe in the scriptures. When God breathed on dirt, he got man. When he breathed on man, he got words. The words are not in the dirt, but in the breath. The breath passes from man to man until they return to dirt, the eternal chain of command, the passing of words. And now the words are in our hands. But so often they're only found behind our lips or on our eyes, within church doors in red and black lines, printed on shirts our commitments disguise. What we say is truth, our lives claim is a lie. But I believe in the scriptures, for those scribal scribblings refuse to stay on the page. On paper to lay, but to be resurrected in your flesh as you die to them every day. I believe in the scriptures, for by them, through them, and to them I was made. For they are the words of Genesis, the exodus of shame. They are the words that form my bones and the ones that will call me from the grave. They are the ink on my flesh, the pen on my tongue. They are the words by which creation has begun and through which recreation will be done. They are the words of God, and we are his listeners. I believe God still speaks. I believe in the scriptures.